वेलकम ऑल. सो टुडेज टॉपिक इज द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ कुल देवी एंड देवताज एंड हाउ मच हेल्पफुल दे कैन बी इन आवर डे टू डे लाइव्स. दिस इज़ द टॉपिक. ओके, आई हैव ऑलरेडी मेड वन ऑफ द वीडियोज ऑन कुल देवी देवताज बिफोर एज वेल, बट देन पीपल वॉन्टेड टू नो मोर अबाउट दिस इन अ मोस्ट सिंप्लीफाइड मैनर एज टू इफ सम एग्जाम्पल कैन बी गिवन टू अस दैट in what way it is important for us and why it is important for us to know about our kul devi devtas, that where we belong. Okay, so let's get started. See, first of all, you need to understand that every community, every caste, every gotra has their own ishtadev that you call and kul devi and devtas. Okay, some of you maybe not be aware of this because you are the new generation and maybe in your house this is not followed since you have come to the metropolitan cities or the modern age culture, but that does not mean that this thing is not important or this thing does not exist. Now what happens is that every, in fact not even I would say a community, individually also every person has an energy, a vibration which connects with a certain kind of a positive energy when you're talking about the divine energies. Okay, the different kinds of divine energies, different kinds of positive energies or spiritual energies which are associated with each one of us. Okay, what I'm trying to say is that basically praying to one particular energy can benefit you more than maybe other kind of energy. That means, for example, Lord Shiva is there, and I'm not trying to segregate gods and goddesses here. I'm just trying to quote an example for explanation in a layman's language. For example, Lord Shiva is there, okay, and if Lord Shiva's prayers and meditation and sadhanas or simple puja or remembering Lord Shiva and enchanting his mantras suits best for you as per your horoscope, as per your nakshatras, then if you will pray to Goddess Durga in comparison, it will definitely benefit you because it's a positive energy, it's a collective energy which is really really positive and divine energy. But the maximum benefit that you will attain out is through Lord Shiva's puja and prayers. You understanding? So what I'm going to say is that every person has his or her own god and goddesses whose energy will suit you the best. So it is important for you to know that which energy suits you the maximum. Okay, and also important for you to know that who is your kul devi and devta. Okay, now what is the significance for it? Like I said, maximum benefits, maximum growth aspects, peace of mind is associated with the energy, the spiritual energy, the divine energy that suits you. Okay, and the degree that suits you. So this is important for you to know. So now if you have not started praying your kul devi devtas yet, or that particular energy or the god or the goddesses that suits you the most, what's going to happen is that even if things are moving in your life in a positive way, you will still feel there is something missing, you will still feel incomplete, you will still feel stagnant over a period of time over something or over some matter. You understanding? So this is what exactly I'm trying to say, that kul devi and devtas bless you individually because they are associated with your family lineage in the past. Your ancestors are also associated with the kul devi devtas when it comes to their blessings and their availability for your community. Now, I'm not saying that God differentiates between this community or that community. No, I'm just trying to say there's certain nakshatra, certain amount of your horoscope things, the calculations, the time that you were born, all that is associated with particular planets, and planets are associated with different energies of Devi Devtas, which are living beings. Okay, the God element that you may call in the modern times. So this is what it is, that it is important for you to know your kul devi devtas, because the moment you get to know about them and you start enchanting their mantras, or if you have a guru, and you have got a deeksha from the guru, your guru can actually tell you that this particular mantra will suit you of this ishtadev of yours or kul devi or devta. Okay, so it is very important for you to know that. And if you have not known till now, it is important for you to give your horoscope. Now for people who are not aware, okay, fine. Guru Didi said this in the video that it is important for us to know, but we are not aware of. because nobody from our house told, and we were not following this before, but now we think that we should. What should we do? This is the next question that can come in your mind. So the answer is, you can get the diagnosis done for your Kul Devi and Devtas to know that which Kul Devi Devta you belong to, okay, and whom you should be praying, and which family lineage that your family lineage was following, which Kul Devi and Devta that you belong to, okay. So that can be done through your horoscope, through your photograph, through your horoscope, that you give the timing, the date of birth and all of that, your names, and we can find out that which god goddess energy will suit you the most, and which god goddesses you should pray, and even your Ishtadev, who is your Ishtadev and who is your Kuldevi and Devtas. Okay, this is the simplest way I've explained. Maybe a few things I've repeated in the form of explanation, so that it drills inside your mind that what exactly I'm talking about, and there should be no confusion. Okay, so this is about it. So if you want to know who are your Kul Devi and Devtas, who is your Ishtadev, you can get the diagnosis done, which is of course a paid service, and get to know about it. And even if for that matter you want to know a particular mantra that which will suit you, that also we can tell you through the diagnosis. Okay, so since Diwali is approaching, and a lot of you have already asked this question, that we want to do a Kul Devi puja on Diwali along with Goddess Lakshmi, this is the reason that we are uploading this video. Okay, so that's about it. If there's any more questions regarding this topic or any other topic, you can write on the Gmail given in the description section on the YouTube channel, and the team will revert back to you. Okay, but no phone calls please, only the Gmail, because we don't pick up calls, extremely busy with cases. I always say that on YouTube. Okay, so that's about it. Next week I'll come up with another topic. Till then, goodbye.